Hi there, my name is Jakob and I'm an environment artist for Quixel at Epic Games. This is the second part of our small tutorial series on the Roman-inspired fantasy environment. In this one, we'll be taking a look at remixing Megascans assets, quick and dirty asset repurposing using decals, material editing and hacking assets, as well as more complex asset repurposing, specifically our large hero asset, the Roman head scan. If this is the first video of this series you're watching, I'd highly recommend checking out the previous part, in which I go over my process from idea of a concept to finished environment. So, without any further ado, let's jump in. When talking about remixing assets, the most straightforward way of doing it is most likely using Mixer. Now, Mixer allows you to quickly and non-destructively change and create materials using both scan data and procedurally generated effects. In this case, I wanted something nice and shiny for my scene. Something that would look old, valuable, you know, fitting for a goddess shrine. I found a clay cup in the Megascans library that had a nicely humble yet still interesting silhouette and nice ornamental detail on it. But while the shape was great, the clay material certainly didn't fit what I had in mind, so I opened up Mixer, loaded the 3D asset and just started playing around. I used the gold smart material as a base to get started, an old rotten flesh scan for some nice albedo variation, and then mostly solid layers for added albedo and roughness detail to really turn this clay muck into something that looked old and detailed. The entire setup was kept really simple, only using a few layers and very basic mask stacks. All in all, the process did not take longer than 5 minutes, and saving this mix as a smart material will allow me to use it on further projects down the line. And just like that, we have an awesome shiny gold cup ready to be thrown into our scene. Another way of repurposing a Megascan scan asset is by modifying or hacking it. Now you can go all out on this, but in my case I really just kept it as simple as possible. I wanted to have lanterns in my scene, but since we didn't have any appropriate scans, I just decided to take our instance burner scan, chop off the bottom, flip the top and throw it back into Unreal Engine. I kept kitbashing scans of ours like that throughout the entire project, but you can get a lot more creative with it than what I did. Especially when working on a more conceptual piece, so not a game level, a piece where you can have full control over your camera, your distance to objects. This is a great way of adding coherent details using minimal amounts of effort, being able to create results quickly. Now, as I mentioned before, you can really go all out on this, especially if time is not a deciding factor. You could, for example, take this minecart and any 3D toolset of your liking, for example 3ds Max, ZBrush, Maya, Blender, Cinema 4D, and just delete the coal, instead replace it with gold bars or an assortment of nicely shaded gems. Not only would this elevate the appearance of the object, but it would also allow for a wider range of narrative purposes that you could use this asset for. One of my favorite techniques for altering an asset's appearance is by having a comprehensive master material setup in Unreal Engine 4 that allows for full material flexibility. In this case, it allowed me to take our super rusty and dirty incense burners and give them a bit of a digital polish. What I'm really doing here is essentially breaking our scanned PBR values, however, I'm breaking them with artistic purpose. It's good and important to know the rules, but it's more important to know the rules so you know when to break them. In this case, it was very important to account for quick art directability and easy variations. So with this approach, I was able to hit all these checkmarks by still using our original scan data. Another great on-the-fly customization method is using decals. Now, decals allow you to tie assets together, adding major detail passes and elevating environmental storytelling. In this particular case, I upscaled these broken columns, but to really sell the scale, I firstly needed to add a tiling detail normal pass to my material to ensure that I have sufficient microscale detail that such a massive object just would have. However, all the rest of the details are 100% in-engine decal work, allowing me to properly art direct what my camera sees. being able to take both large and small details, playing around with them and adapting them to the environment as needed, is just a fantastic way of ensuring that your details and your storytelling are on point. Additionally, it ties different objects together. For instance, all of my columns have a layer of chipped, cracked red paint over them, suggesting that they were all once embellished with beautiful plaster artistry. Just make sure that really only the objects you want actually receive decals to achieve the desired layering of detail. Now, by far the most complicated remixing of a Megascans asset in this scene is our hero asset, the Roman head scan. You can approach such a task in many different ways. The solution that I opted for just perfectly fit my needs in this very case. Right out of the gate, I first tried to upscale the head in a similar fashion to how we edited our gold cup from the beginning. 100% mixer texture work, adding a ton of detail and just using more complex blending and construction methods. However, this workflow was not great for getting the super fine small-scale detail I would need for such a ludicrously large structure. I was constantly fighting against textile density, visible tiling, and just overall texture resolution. Additionally, it was really hard to judge how the asset would look in my scene in its massive scale compared to Mixer. That's why I decided to proceed as non-destructively as possible. So instead of mixing textures in Mixer and exporting them as non-editable texture sets, I created a master material that would allow me to mix assets in Unreal Engine similarly to how I'd mix them in Mixer, at least to an extent. This non-destructive approach allowed, again, for great directability, adjustability, and quick changes on the fly. With this setup, I can not only adjust material parameters, but even switch out entire material layers directly in engine. Furthermore, I can finally avoid and hide tiling while still achieving the textile density necessary for the object. Instead of creating a final material in Mixer, I used its procedural masking capabilities to create an RGB mask in which each color channel contains its own masking information for one specific material type. In this case, I accounted for mossy growth, heavy damage, and directional weathering. This mask then powers a four-way material blend, masking four large-scale texture sets I created in Mixer to really minimize necessary tiling on such a large surface area. All of these material layers are rather simple in their setup, and the masks are only used for a straightforward blur between my four materials. To further hide tiling, add detail, and just really tie these four materials together, I used additional tiling world-aligned masks that I also created in Mixer, vertex paint inputs, and a fully parameterized tiling color variation function, powering albedo and roughness variation. While we haven't spent a ton of time covering every single parameter of this material, the entire project is available on the Unreal Engine Marketplace for you to download and dive into. So I would highly encourage you to open up this material yourself, so you can really go through it at your own pace. To summarize my approach for this on-the-fly concept environment, I'd encourage all of you to be free to misuse assets or use scans as blueprints or placeholders for custom assets. Really just try to not be limited by the expectations of using photogrammetry. Photogrammetry is a great tool, but it's still sort of the artist behind it that makes it work. Now, thank you all so much for sticking around. I hope you all enjoyed it. Make sure to tune into my next video and our final chapter of this small tutorial series, in which I'll be diving into working with Unreal Engine, troubleshooting, and the topic of technical adaptation. If you have any thoughts or questions, feel free to add them to the comments of this video, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.